Namaste everyone and welcome back to Live Stronger. Today we are going to exercise our legs again. Yes, we keep working on our legs. But yes, those are the foundational exercises which will help us in building a strong foundation. So straight away I'm going to start with the greatest stretch, 5 repetitions on each side, the usual, every day, all times. So I'm going to speed up the video because I hope you by now you have already caught up with this particular stretch and you're able to do this seamlessly. If not, still you're taking time switching from one side to the other, absolutely fine. Take your time, give those 2 to 3 minutes for this particular stretch. Feel the mobility coming up slowly. Every day try to push yourself a little bit more in this particular stretch. Try to, you know, increase the length of your muscles through the movement. Little bit effort every day would take us a long distance over a period of time with the consistency. Post the greatest stretch, I'm going to do my hip openers for my internal thigh stretches. So simply holding a kettlebell and pushing yourself onto one side. We have done this previously. We have been doing this on every leg day to ensure that our legs are completely mobile, our hips are opened for all kind of squatting and lunging movements. This time I have figured out that the restriction I have been feeling in my left leg was mostly because of my IT band. So I have also done a stability drill, which I'll be showing you next. But this particular exercise or this particular stretch also helps in terms of getting that IT band issue fixed because we are working on our inner thigh mobility. Now make sure you squeeze your glutes every time before you push your knee over your toes. Squeezing those glutes activates the hip thrust and basically your hips open up a little bit more, and then as you push yourself aside, there's a greater stretch happening in your inner thighs. Thus, you know, good amount of mobility is regained if there is any kind of restriction. Do 5 repetitions each side. You may or may not hold on to a weight. This time the kettlebells were busy, so just a 4 kilo kettlebell, just not much, but whatever I could grab, I grabbed it and started doing the repetitions. I focused on slow tempo to get as larger stretch as possible. 5 repetitions each side. You need not take a break in between. Then post immediately completing my hip openers, I switch to the deep squat, leaning forward by pushing my glutes as far behind as possible and sitting down in a deep squat. Once in the deep squat, I shift my body weight onto one ankle at a time to improve my ankle mobility also. Here, if you feel a restriction, massaging your calves would relieve you from some tightness at least. But I hope by now you're able to squat deep, at least with your body weight. If still you feel restricted, please make sure to identify where the restriction lies and start working on those areas, especially in terms of foam rolling. Now here is the stability drill which I have done to ensure my IT band issue doesn't pop up while I'm going to do the squats for today. So I simply put on a resistance band onto a, I fixed it at one end and then put my knee through it and then started doing single leg squats, just a little bit of motion while the resistance band is pulling me. So that what is this doing? This is basically forcing my hips to remain open while I squat down. So taking off the tension from the IT band, making the IT band relax a little bit as I squat down and making sure my hips and my glutes are working properly. Also helping my glute medius fire up to make sure my hips remain open during the squatting movement. I've done 15 repetitions of it for 2 sets. Now straight away I jumped into my warm-up sets for my squats. As usual, empty bar warm-up repetitions, about 2 sets, 12 to 15 repetitions. If you're someone who doesn't feel the blood rushing through or the muscles are ready in 2 sets, you can definitely do a 3rd set. If you're someone who gets fatigued very quickly in your legs, 1 warm-up set is also absolutely fine, about 12 to 15 repetitions. Make sure you go as deep as possible and keep your torso straight. For my starting weight, I chose to go with a challenging weight, with an enough weight, because I still did not want to fire my IT band up again, but taking the cue of squeezing my glutes before every repetition and taking in a big breath, bracing my core, really helped me execute my repetitions without any kind of an issue. I was able to almost go for parallel length. At times I tried to go deep, but there was still a little bit of tightness, so I just stopped myself at parallel. Almost my thighs were parallel to the floor, so I stopped there. I've done 4 sets of it, about 8 to 10 repetitions every set, taking a 60 second break in between. If you are someone who is aiming to go a little bit higher on weight, the rest period will increase significantly. You might need to even take 2 to 3 minutes break. But if you're sticking to a challenging weight all throughout, I just increased 5 kilos every set, started with 40 kilos in total. So that's it for my squats. For my second exercise, I started doing the seated hamstring curls again, the alternative leg fashion way, making sure I get maximum amount of contraction in each of my legs without one leg working more than the other. I like this particular style, and I'm going to continue doing the similar way, because the amount of contractions I'm able to get through this alternative method is quite excellent for me, because by third set my legs were fried, my hamstrings were completely tired. So every time I do the alternative leg, and once my legs are no more able to push the weight alone, I use both my legs to get another 5 to 6 repetitions in. So total I was able to achieve 12 to 15 repetitions for both my legs. The break in between was short, 60 seconds. If you want, you can take a longer period, about 2 minutes. Again, I did 4 sets of it. Every set I followed the same style, starting with alternative and then switching to both my legs for my last few reps to get that drop set effect. So instead of just dropping the weight, you can do this method because it's how we drop. If you want, you can take it one step forward, you can drop the weight with both your legs and continue to get another 3 or 4 reps. But otherwise, 12 to 15 repetitions, 4 sets is more than good enough if you choose a challenging weight to start off with. Make sure you don't do progressive overload. Instead, you start with a heavier weight. Now for my third exercise, I chose to do my forearm work, wherein I took a barbell and started curling them up with my wrist behind my back, working my inner forearm. Now I've done 3 sets of it, about 12 to 15 repetitions with a challenging enough weight. The first set went a little bit easy. The second and third started becoming tough as blood started accumulating in my forearm. So again, a great exercise to improve the strength of our forearms. And that's it. We're done for the day. Yes, very short and very easy workout. My legs were absolutely done because the amount of squatting I did, the amount of hamstring curls I did, I got maximum amount of mind muscle connection, and my legs were completely full of blood, and my forearms also felt great. So I immediately said, okay, that's it for today. Let me give enough time for recovery because I'm hitting my legs very quickly after every second or third day. So I moved on to my static stretches, wherein I hold for 20 seconds, 2 times for my quads and my hamstrings. So if you did like the video, I would definitely appreciate a like. If you have any kind of feedback, please do drop a comment. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please do, because it's a lot of positive feedback to me, helps me reach more people. Please do share with your family members and friends whom you think this particular transformative explanatory video helps, because you can work along with me and try to follow the cues to get better out of your workout without stressing much. Once done with my quad stretches, remember this quad stretch is pretty simple. We have done this earlier also. You can do it just by holding with your hands. I just chose to do with the Smith machine because I was a bit tired. So I just racked the Smith machine and put my legs on it and started stretching my quads. And the same thing I did for my hamstrings, two repetitions for both my legs. With a 20 second hold, my legs were absolutely tired. I was unable to get them up after every repetition, but then I managed to. Make sure you hold the stretches for 20 seconds because that's when you get the maximum amount of stretch ability, or the muscle would regain its neutral length. By pushing your glutes and bending forward, you create an exaggeration of the stretch. You can also pull your toes towards your shins to, you know, extend the stretch throughout your calf muscles and your hamstrings. Again, thank you so much for joining me in this video. I know, very short and easy, but sometimes you need to give enough time for your legs to recover, and my legs were a bit sore, so I chose to shift onto a lighter amount of exercise. I will see you in the next video, wherein we start switching our workout profile a little bit. Thank you and have a good day.